The Prime Minister's weakness has emboldened those who continue to illegally blockade our ports, roads and railways. The Prime Minister is also blocking investment in this country by cancelling approved projects and creating insurmountable political uncertainty for others. Hundreds of billions of dollars and hundreds of thousands of jobs right across the country have been lost as a direct result of his weak leadership. Yeah. When will the Prime Minister finally stand up to the anti-energy activists in his own caucus, stand up to those blockading our economy, and stand up for Canadian jobs?
Yeah. The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Natural Resources.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Our government has been steadfast in its support for the hardworking men and women in our oil and gas sector. It's why we approved the Line 3 replacement project and why we always supported Keystone XL, where construction will soon begin in the U.S. Let's remember there are thousands of good, well-paying jobs that have been created in Alberta and BC because we did the hard work to get TMX right. We believe in the workers in the sector, we believe in their families who have their backs. That's what Mr. President.
The Honourable Member for Chilliwack-Hope.
The Prime Minister's weak leadership is also failing Indigenous communities. When he killed the Northern Gateway pipeline, he stole a 33% equity stake and $2 billion in economic benefits from Northern Indigenous communities. When the Tech Frontier mine was cancelled because of the political uncertainty he created, the Prime Minister tore economic hope out of the hands of the 14 Indigenous communities who had signed agreements in place. How does it advance the cause of reconciliation when the Prime Minister does everything that he can to keep Northern Indigenous communities in poverty forever?
The Honourable Minister of the Environment.
Mr. Speaker, as I said earlier, this was a decision taken by the company. We respect that decision. I'm sure it was a difficult one. I will say, though, that during the process, the environmental assessment process that was conducted under CIA 2012, that the company did incredibly good work in engaging Indigenous communities in Alberta near the project. That is certainly something that can be a model for companies going forward.
Here, here.